Now will you note verse 4? And being assembled together with them, commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father, which saith he, ye have heard of me. Now they are to wait for the coming of the Holy Spirit, and they are to wait until that takes place. For John truly baptized with water, but ye shall be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days hence. Now I want to call your attention to something that is very important here. He appears to them now with these instructions, and he says that the thing that's going to take place is that you're going to be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days hence. Now, may I say here that the promise of the Father is the Holy Spirit, and there are two baptisms that I think that I ought to call your attention to. You'll be baptized with the Holy Spirit. Now, water baptism is ritual baptism, and I believe in it. The Holy Spirit is real baptism, the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Now, when you read in chapter 2 of the book of Acts of the day of Pentecost, you'll find out there's no mention of them being baptized. The mention there is that they were filled with the Holy Spirit. The important thing is the filling of the Holy Spirit. It's not the baptism of the Holy Spirit for experience. The baptism of the Holy Spirit, as we shall see, is what puts you in the body of believers. It puts you in the body of believers, the church. And that's the reason we're going to see in chapter 2 what happened on the day of Pentecost. The Holy Spirit came to do what? Put them in the body of believers. Now, in order that they might serve, we're told in Acts 2 they were filled with the Holy Spirit. And that, of course, means that the other ministries of the Holy Spirit were performed. And that I consider very important indeed. And we need to, I think, notice that. Now, I want to move on in this particular section here because we're going to emphasize all of this when we come to it in chapter 2.